بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، dear respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In this episode, I'll be speaking about the story of one of the great women. This lady is a very honorable lady. I'm speaking about some of the great women in Islam. Why? Because we don't want to think that there were no great women in our history. In fact, some people might think there are great sahabiyat, or there were great sahabiyat companions, female companions only. But in fact, there were many great female tabi'een from the tabi'een themselves. And this should encourage all our sisters to set those sahabiyat and those tabi'iyat as role models for themselves. The personality that we are going to discuss in this episode is Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Let me repeat the name. Does that ring a bell? Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Her father is Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, if you remember, brothers and sisters, is one of the 10 people granted to Jannah. You know, in the very famous hadith Abdurrahman ibn Auf, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Abu Bakr fil Jannah, Umar fil Jannah, Uthman fil Jannah, Ali fil Jannah. Then he said, Talha ibn Ubaidillah fil Jannah, Az-Zubayr fil Jannah. Then Abdurrahman ibn Auf fil Jannah and Sa'd wa Sa'id fi al Jannah. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas and Sa'id ibn Zayd fil Jannah. All these 10 people are known as the 10 people granted to Jannah. It doesn't mean that there are no other people granted Jannah, but these 10 people were known for this hadith, because all of them were mentioned in one hadith, and the Prophet ﷺ explicitly said that they are granted Jannah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, he was one of the great Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to love him so much. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to say, if you like to see one who has completed his duties in the dunya, then look at Talha ibn Ubaidillah. In fact, this hadith has been narrated, or was narrated, by Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and the one who narrated this hadith from Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha is Aisha bint Talha, his daughter, the daughter of Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the father of Aisha. As we said, he was a very great sahabi, and he was the one who protected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam during the Battle of Uhud. You know, during the Battle of Uhud, Muslims were about to be defeated, and even one of the mushriks used to say that the Prophet, or he said that Muhammad qutil. And some of them, they were fighting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In one narration, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was chased by some people from mushriks, and they were trying to approach the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to kill him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, who is going to fight them? So Talha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu immediately said, I will fight them, ya Rasulallah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, no, wait a minute. And then another sahabi came and he fought them and he was killed. Then some mushriks were chasing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam again, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, who will fight them? And Talha again said, I will fight them, ya Rasulallah. Until 11 of the sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum were killed, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam each time was saying to Talha, no, hold on, wait a minute. Until the 12th, or after 11 people were killed, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam allowed Talha to fight. And Talha fought until he had more than 30 injuries in his body. In fact, there was a narration that Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that I was injured in all parts of my body until I was injured in my private part. And he was known that he was trying to protect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by his body and by his hand until the mushriks, they injured his hand until his hand became paralyzed. So he lost his hand, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to love him so much. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about him and Az-Zubayr, Talha and Az-Zubayr, they are my neighbors in Jannah. Talha and Az-Zubayr, they are my neighbors in Jannah. One narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, at the day of Uhud, I was fighting, and on my right side was Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel Jibreel alayhi salam, and on my left side was who? Was Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. You know the fitna that took place between Talha, Az-Zubayr, and Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha. From one side, and Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu from another side. So when the fitna took place, some people thought that there is hatred between Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu and the other party, but that was not true. Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu once met Umran ibn Talha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and he said, wallahi, I wish that me and your father will be gathered together in the day of resurrection as Allah in Jannah, as Allah Jalla wa Ala said, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا عَلَى صُرُورٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. We have removed any hatred from their hearts, and they will be meeting each other, lying on beds next to each other in paradise. So Ali bin Abi Talib said this statement to Imran, the son of Talha. So this is an answer for those who thought that there was hatred between them, or the fitna that took place between them caused hatred between them. He said, Talha, Ali bin Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, what happened, happened, and insha'Allah, we will be among the people who will be gathered and staying together in Jannah. So some people heard Ali bin Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they said that we believe that Allah Jalla wa Ala will be, Allah Jalla wa Ala is more just than putting Talha and Az-Zubayr in Jannah. Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu became very angry, and he said, if this ayah is not applicable on our situation, then who are included in this ayah? Who are the people who will be included in this ayah? Which means that definitely Talha and Az-Zubayr and the other people who were granted in Jannah are included in this ayah, irrespective of the fitna that took place between them. You know that Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu was killed in Al-Jamal, the battle of Al-Jamal, and as we said, Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very sad for this. He was killed in the year of 36 for Hijrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. His daughter is Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Who was her mother? Her mother is Kulthum bint Abi Bakr. Kulthum is the daughter of Abi Bakr, which means that Aisha bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is her maternal auntie. So her maternal auntie was Aisha, the greatest women in Islam, or one of the greatest women in Islam, along with Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. So Aisha bint Talha grew up in that environment. Her mother is Kulthum bint Abi Bakr. Her maternal auntie is Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So she took ilm from them. And she was a great woman because of this. In fact, they said that she used to look like Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, very similar to Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And that's why even the caliphs of Umayyah, they used to respect her so much. And she used to visit Hisham ibn Abdul Malik, and she used to admonish Hisham ibn Abdul Malik, and he used to listen to her. Aisha Bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha, as we said that she was a very honorable lady, and she narrated a number of the ahadith, and they said her ahadith are recorded in the six main books of ahadith. Let me just narrate some of the ahadith that she has narrated, because some of them has certain meanings. One of the ahadith that she has narrated is through Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So Aisha bint Talha said, I heard Aisha bint Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said that once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting and Fatima bint Muhammad came. And wallahi, she walks like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks. ما تخطئ مشيتها مشيته. Very similar to the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stood up for her, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam embraced her, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kissed her. And then in another narration she said, whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to receive Fatima, his daughter, he used to do this. And whenever Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha used to receive the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she used to welcome him, and she used to embrace him and kiss him. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said something to Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, and Fatima became sad. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to her something more. And then Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, his daughter, became happy. And then Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Fatima that she will be the first person to die after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, let me repeat this. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Fatima that he is going to die soon. His ajal became very soon. So Aisha, Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha became very sad. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, do you know that you will be the first person to follow me? So Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha became very happy. And they said that Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, died after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she died a few months later. Aisha bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha also narrated another hadith, the very famous hadith that I will mention the hadith insha'Allah after the break, because they are telling me that we have to have a break now. Let us have the break and we will continue after the break. Stay tuned.
We're going to look how to create a website and which Islamic websites to actually visit. What inspired you to create your own website?
One of the challenges that we face every day, the site or the application should be accessible worldwide. I remember when I was younger, one of my friends asked me to convince his father to get him a desktop, even the laptop. If you compare both of them in terms of cost, laptop roughly cost twice the money if you compare it with a desktop.
Hackers, the word hackers, most of the youth people are very interested about that word. They say, hey, I'd like to be a hacker, because there is a type of hacker doing a great job. We call them white hat hacker.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. We are discussing the story of Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah رضي الله تعالى عنها وعن أبيها. May Allah جل وعلا be pleased with her and her father. We were mentioning some of the ahadith that she narrated, and she took from Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. In the other hadith, Aisha bint Talha said that Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, "Are we obliged to do jihad?" The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "No jihad is obligatory upon you. No jihad is obligatory upon you. But your jihad is what? Is Hajj and Umrah. Your jihad is Hajj and Umrah." This is one of her ahadith. Aisha bint Talha radiyallahu ta'ala anha was one time sitting with Aisha bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And her husband came. Who was her husband? Her husband is Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr. So her cousin, Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha, was her first husband. And they said that she was a very beautiful lady, very honorable lady. So Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr as-Siddiq came, and he saw Aisha, his wife, bint Talha, and of course his auntie, Aisha bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, family. So when Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman came, Aisha, his auntie, told him, "Why don't you approach your wife, the other Aisha, and maybe embrace her, kiss her?" So he was amazed. Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, he said, "I am fasting. Am I allowed to do this?" In some narrations, Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to kiss when he was fasting. So she was teaching him this in a practical way. And among the other ahadith, among the other stories of Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, in fact, let me just mention about her husbands. We said that the first husband is Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr as-Siddiq. Then after he died, Mus'ab ibn Zubayr, the Amir of Iraq, got married to her. And then after Mus'ab ibn Zubayr, another person called Umar ibn Abdullah al-Taymi married her, and he gave her, as many historians said, he gave her a dowry of 1 million dirham. 1,000 of 1,000, as they used to say, 1 million dirhams. And that's why some people were unhappy with this, and they had the very famous poetry where they said, "أبضع امرأة بألف ألف درهم وتبيت سادات الجيوش جياعة." Means you give as a mahar 1,000 of 1,000, 1 million dirhams, and the other people who are the soldiers of the army of Muslims don't get this, and some of them even stay hungry. Anyway, I don't want to dwell into this, but this is just something to be mentioned. We said that her second husband was Mus'ab ibn Zubayr. Before she got married to Mus'ab ibn Zubayr, some people told her that Mus'ab ibn Zubayr is interested in getting married to you. She said, "What? I will not marry anyone after my first husband, Abdullah ibn Abdurrahman ibn Abi Bakr as-Siddiq." In fact, she said, "If he is unlawful to me, as my father is unlawful to me." This is called dhihar. This is a very interesting mas'ala. Normally, the husband says to his wife that she is unlawful to him as his mother is unlawful to him. This is dhihar. And you know, the ayat of dhihar are known, وَالَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْكُمْ مِنْ نِسَائِهِمْ, mentioned in Surah Al-Mujadala. And the expiation of dhihar, when a person says to his wife, "You are unlawful to me as my wife, as my mother is unlawful to me," the expiation for this is what? As Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, فَتَحْرِيرُ رَقَبَةٍ, to free a slave person. To free a slave person. If he can't find a slave, if he can't free a slave person, then what? Then he has to fast 2 consecutive months. Now, if a woman says about a man, he will be unlawful to me as my father is unlawful to me, what is the expiation for this? The scholars have 3 opinions regarding this. I hope that the mas'ala is clear. As we said that in these stories, we are not just narrating stories. We will try to get some knowledge from those stories and we will try to expand on those stories. So, and this is almost the only story where a lady gave dhihar to a man. And that's why in the books of fiqh, you will always read this story when you come to the issue of dhihar given by a woman, not given by a man. The story of Aisha bint Talha, radiallahu ta'ala anha. So Imam Ahmad said, or the Hanabila had 3 opinions. Or Imam Ahmad said that there are 3 opinions. First of all, she have to free a slave person as if the dhihar was given from a man to his wife. The other riwayah, the other opinion is that there is no expiation. And the third one is this should be treated as a yameen. And what is the kafara of a yameen? As you know, that the kafara of yameen, 3 choices. As Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned in the Quran, فَكَفَّارَةُ إِطْعَامُ عَشَرَةِ مَسَاكِينَ مِنْ أَوْسَطِ مَا تُطْعِمُونَ أَهْلِيكُمْ أَوْ كِسْوَتُهُمْ أَوْ تَحْرِيرُ رَقَبَةٍ فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ فَصِيَامُ 3 أيام. To feed 10 poor people or give them clothes or free a person, free a slave person. Then if you can't do this, then fast 3 days. So these are the 3 opinions, and this is the story of Aisha bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha, in which this fiqhi mas'ala was built. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha saw a dream. So that a person is saying, or saw in fact, that her father, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, who was killed as a shaheed, came to her and he told her, "Oh my daughter, remove me from the place I am in." In another word, his grave, because there is something that has annoyed me. So when she woke up, she said to some of her servants, "Let us go to my father's grave." So they took Talha ibn Ubaidillah from the grave, and they said, "Wallahi, nothing has changed from his body except just a few hairs, a few threads of hair. Nothing has changed." The narrator said there were 30 years between the killing of Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu as a shaheed and the time they removed him from that place to another place radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa anha. This is the story of Aisha bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha, a very honorable lady. And we are mentioning her story to set an example for our sisters to have some role models from women themselves. She used to be a very pious lady. She used to do a lot of ibadah radiallahu ta'ala anha. And they have mentioned about her ibadah and about her dignity. They mentioned a lot about her generosity radiallahu ta'ala anha. And we said that she used to visit the people of Umayyah, Bani Umayyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, and she used to give them advices and they used to respect her and not do anything to her because of her position in Islam. They said that she lived a very long period of life and she died after the year 100. She died after the year 100. May Allah Jalla wa Ala be pleased with Aisha bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and may Allah Jalla wa Ala be pleased with her teacher Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha bint Abi Bakr al-Siddiq. Inshallah, this is the end of the story of Aisha bint Talha radiallahu ta'ala anha. I hope that in the coming episode, we can, inshallah, discuss a story of another honorable lady from the Tabi'in. جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم May Allah جل وعلا benefit us from those stories. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Very famous hadith, hadith Abd Rahman ibn Auf, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Abu Bakr fil Jannah, Umar fil Jannah, Uthman fil Jannah, Ali fil Jannah. Then he said, Talha ibn Ubaidillah fil Jannah, Az-Zubayr fil Jannah, then Abd Rahman ibn Auf fil Jannah, and Sa'd wa Sa'id fil Jannah. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas and Sa'id ibn Zayd fil Jannah. All these 10 people called are known as the 10 people granted to Jannah. It doesn't mean that there are no other people granted Jannah, but these 10 people were known for this hadith because all of them were mentioned in one hadith, and the Prophet ﷺ explicitly said that they are granted Jannah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, he was one of the great Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love him so much. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to study. In fact, some people might think there are great sahabiyat, or there were great sahabiyat companions, female companions only. But in fact, there were many great female tabi'een from the tabi'een themselves. And this should encourage all our sisters to set those sahabiyat and those tabi'iyat as role models for themselves. The personality that we are going to discuss in this episode is Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Let me repeat the name. Does that ring a bell? Aisha bint Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Her father is Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, if you remember, brothers and sisters, is one of the 10 people granted to Jannah. Used to say, if you like to see one who has completed his duties in the dunya, then look at Talha ibn Ubaidillah. In fact, this hadith has been narrated or was narrated by Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And the one who narrated this hadith from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha is Aisha bint Talha, his daughter, the daughter of Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the father of Aisha. As we said, he was a very great sahabi, and he was the one who protected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam during the Battle of Uhud. You know, during the Battle of Uhud, Muslims were about to be defeated, and even one of the mushriks used to say that the Prophet, or he said that Muhammad qutil. And some of them, they were fighting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد Dear respected brothers and sisters السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته In this episode I'll be speaking about the story of one of the great women This lady is a very honorable lady I'm speaking about some of the great women in Islam. Why? Because we don't want to think that there were no great women in our Islam. In one narration, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was chased by some people from mushriks, and they were trying to approach the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to kill him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Who is going to fight them?" So Talha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu immediately said, "I will fight them, ya Rasulallah." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "No, wait a minute." And then another Sahabi came and he fought them and he was killed. Then some mushriks were chasing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam again. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Who will fight them?" And Talha again said, "I will fight them, ya Rasulallah." Until 11 of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum were killed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam each time was saying to Talha, "No, hold on, wait a minute." Until the 12th or after 11 people were killed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam allowed Talha to fight. And Talha fought